In this video, I will show you how to compile and run the unit test in command line. You know, sometimes we need to compile and execute tests in a command line instead of in an IDE. And suppose that we have our Java source files here, the Java project source folder, and we have this Java source files here, and I use a text editor, textpad. You see, this is the test class user DAO test. You see another test class product DAO test. The product DAO DAO test calls the product DAO class, you see here, and the product DAO class calls the product class, you see here. You see, for demos, for demonstration purpose, so it is empty. Okay, similarly, the user DAO test uses the user DAO test, you see. And the user DAO test user DAO test calls the user DAO class, and the user DAO class calls the user class, you see. Now let's compile these classes first. Open command prompt. You see command prompt in Windows. I change the current directory to the project directory here. Copy this CD and paste. Enter. Change to the drive. You see, in this source directory, we have the Java source files here, product.java, product.dao.java, product DAO test .java, and so on. And to compile the normal Java class is very simple. As you can see, the user DAO class doesn't have any dependency, so you can just use the Java C command and user DAO.java. Cannot fashionable user class, so we need to compile the user class as well. Java C user.java. Compile the next model class is product.java. Sorry, Java C product.java. And compile the user DAO.java. Sorry, we use this package, so let's remove the package. Okay. Suppose in simplest case, we have no package in our code. Okay. You see the test class. Okay, compile it. Okay, and compile the product DAO.java class. Okay, and you see we have the dot class files here as a result of the compile. And now let's try to compile the user DAO test class. Java C user DAO test.java. You see we have 6 errors because this class depends on JUnit library, so we need to have JUnit the jar file to be present in the class path. So you need to go to the JUnit homepage. In this video, I use the JUnit 4, so go for with the JUnit 4. Click on download and install. Click here to download the JUnit JAR file. In this Maven page here, click on the we download the version JUnit 4.12. Click on the JAR link here and save it in a project in the same source folder of the Java class file. This is a similar case, okay? You see the JUnit JAR file appears here, and the second JAR file we need to have is a hump crest called JAR. Okay, we choose the version 1.3 and click on the JAR link here and click save. Okay, now we have two JAR files here for the JUnit library. And now to compile the test class, in the command line we have to specify this the JUnit JAR file in the class path Java C, use a CP switch, use a CP switch and specify the JUnit JAR file, okay, and plus the dot. The dot denotes the current directory, so Java compiler can also find the Java source files. We compile the user DIL test.java. Enter. You see, it compiles successfully. Now let's see, we have the user DIL test.class file here. Okay, we compile the product DIL test, product DIL test.java. Let's see, all in the class files. You see, we have all the Java source file compiled to a dot class files here. This is a Java files. You see, Java files and class files. Now let's run the user DIL test class in a command line. When compile, we need only the JUnit JAR file in the class path, but when running the test class, we also need to specify the hump crest JAR file in the class path. Okay, so we use a Java C command, CP switch, JUnit. Press the tab key, so the command prompt on Windows, we suggest the file names automatically, and hump crest, okay, dot, and we use the Java command, not Java C, to run the test class. Now let's run the user DIL test, okay. So you see, we use a Java command and specify the JUnit jar file and Hamcast jar file in the class path. And to run test class from command line, we need to specify the main class, which is the unit core. Okay, no problem. I show you now. We need to specify the oiz.theunit.runner.theunit.core. This is the main class, the unit runner class, and followed by the test class user DAO test and hit enter. You see, the unit has run successfully, and you see the unit version 4.12. There was one failure in the test delete method of the user DAO test. You see. Now let's see the user DAO test. You see the test delete fails because we use the fail method here. Now let's try to assert to. Okay. Let's compile the user DAO test again. Compile. You see this command to compile the test class. Now, we'll run the user DAO test. Okay. You see, there's no failure now. To test, succeeded. See. Similarly. Let's run the product DAO test class Java C CP JUnit jar Hamcast jar file oiz.theunit.runner.theunit.core is the main runner class, and then the product DAO test. We use a Java command. Okay, it's okay to test succeeded. Let's see the code of the product DAO test. You see, and to run both test classes in the command line. Just specify the class next to the previous one. Here I specify the user DAO test is a second test class to be executed, and you can see in the Java command we specify the main class, the unit core, and then the name of the test classes, hit enter, and you see now the test, the number of tests have been executed is 4. See. So that's how to compile and run JUnit test in a command line on Windows. The important point here is to download the JUnit library jar files, JUnit jar and Hamcast jar, and specify this jar file in the class path when compiling and running the test classes. Thank you for watching.